Welcome to Apple Park in Cupertino, California. Right in front of you is the iconic spaceship. Now, unless you are flying over it, you will never really see the full circular shape of this massive building. From up here, on the top floor of the Apple gift shop, you get one of the best views. If you ever find yourself in Cupertino, I highly recommend stopping by here, grabbing a cup of cappuccino, and hanging out here during sunset. It's free and it's open to public. And honestly, it's a pretty cool experience. I was actually here for the Apple Interactive Stories for VisionOS event as a developer. Learned a lot, met some awesome people, and a huge thank you to anyone who came up and say hi. If I seem a little shy, well, it's just how I am in person. But today, we are not here to talk about the event. I want to show you some real world footage I shot with the Qoocam 3 Ultra VR180 Mod in 8K 3D 180 HDR. Everything you've seen in this video was captured with that camera, and if you are watching it on YouTube VR with a MetaQuest 3, well, you're not actually seeing it in 8K HDR. YouTube doesn't support it yet, and if you really want to experience this footage in full quality, I highly recommend downloading the MVHDVC version on my Patreon and watch it on Apple Vision Pro using our VisionOS app Spatial Film. And it's super easy to do. Just download the file to your download folder using Safari on VisionOS, open Spatial Film, click load video, select 180, find your file and hit play. That's it. And trust me, a lot of the highlight detail won't even be visible unless you're watching in HDR on Vision Pro. So in this video, I will break down how the Qoocam 3 Ultra VR180 Mod handle different shooting scenario, stationary shot, handheld movement, and mounted on a DJI RS4 Mini gimbal, both in daylight and in low light, high ISO conditions. If you are ready, put on your MetaQuest 3 or Apple Vision Pro, and let's dive in. The Qoocam 3 Ultra has a special mode called Dynamic Range Boost, which is also available on the VR180 version. You're looking at it right now. Pay close attention to the highlights, like the bright California sun on your left. Now, here is the same shot in HDR without Dynamic Range Boost. And now we are back with the DR boost again. Honestly, in most situations, the differences is pretty subtle. And here is the trade-off. Dynamic Range Boost introduced chromatic aberration, especially in high contrast areas. Take a look at the metal bars on your left. You will see some color fringing here. Because of this, I don't recommend using DR Boost mode. It feels more like a gimmick than an essential feature. Now, let's talk about 3D quality. The Qoocam 3 Ultra VR180 Mod has a 65mm IPD, which is pretty standard and generally provides a comfortable 3D experience for immersive 180 videos, as long as you are at a normal shooting distance. But the moment you move close to your subject, things start to fall apart. Take the shot of the classic Apple t-shirts. We are about half an arm length away, and already the stereo depth is starting to feel uncomfortable. Now let's go even closer. Right now, your head is practically on the table, looking at an iPhone SE about a foot in front of you. At this distance, the 3D effects completely break down, and if you are watching it in a headset, you're probably feeling the urge to look away. This is the downside of the standard 65mm IPD. For comparison, the Canon EOS VR system uses a 60mm IPD, which allows you to get slightly closer to a subject while still maintaining comfortable 3D depth. But that's just my take. If you have a different experience, let me know in the comment down below. Now let's talk about camera movement in 3D 180. Just a quick warning, this next part might cause motion sickness. One of the biggest advantages of the Qoocam 3 Ultra VR180 Mod is its built-in 9-axis gyro stabilization. This is essentially the successor to the Insta360 EVO, but with even more impressive stabilization, making it one of the most capable action-ready immersive 180 cameras. Here is an example. I'm running toward Kitty on some pretty uneven ground. This is a raw, unstable light footage, and yeah, it's rough. All 3D cameras, including the Canon EOS VR, will look like this if you try to shoot handheld while running. Now, here is the same shot with stabilization applied. It is not perfect, you will see some drifting and vertical movement, but compared to the raw footage, is a massive improvement. Unlike Canon software-based stabilization, the hardware-based stabilization works even in low light and high ISO situation. Here is a perfect example. This shot was taken right after sunset at Apple Park at ISO 6400. The image quality isn't great because of the high ISO, but the stabilization still pretty solid. To take stabilization even further, I recommend using a gimbal like the DJI RS4 Mini. Here are some examples of what that setup can do. I even tested inside a moving car, holding the camera and the gimbal while Kitty was driving. Both the car and Kitty were moving, but thanks to the RS4 Mini AI tracking, she stayed locked in the center of the frame. Having a stable anchor point like this helped reduce motion sickness for viewers, making the experience much more comfortable in a VR headset. Now, even though we have really solid internal and external stabilization solution for the Qoocam 3 Ultra, I still highly recommend keeping your camera on a stick 90% of the time. As you can see from the footage, even with really well stabilized immersive 180 movement, some people will still feel motion sickness, depending on their sensitivity. So, to play it safe, just don't move the camera unless the story really calls for it, like the driving shot you just saw. Finally, let's talk about low light performance. At the end of the day, this is still a sub-$1,000 consumer camera with relatively small sensors, so it's not going to perform anywhere near what a Canon EOS VR system can do in high ISO situation. As you can see, there is a lot of noise in the footage, which is why I wouldn't recommend this camera for low light immersive 1D capture. Finally, I want to show you some immersive 1D photo capture with the Qoocam 3 Ultra using DNGA mode, which let you capture 13K 3D 1D photos. Now, while the resolution sounds impressive, the overall image quality, not so much. It's definitely better than the Calv Gen 2 and Slam Cam in my opinion, but it still doesn't match what you would get from the Canon EOS VR system. But here's the thing, it's really hard to judge image quality without a proper comparison. So in my next deep dive, I will put the Qoocam 3 Ultra VR 180 Mod side by side with the Calv, Insta360 EVO, and Canon EOS VR to see just how much better this little AK setup really is. And if you are interested in creating immersive 1D HDR content for Apple Vision Pro or Meta Quest 3, like what you see here, we will also walk through the easiest way to output high quality HDR 3D 1D video step by step from camera to HMD. If you are a professional filmmaker, you probably wouldn't want to rely on this camera direct output, but don't worry. I will also break down my AI upscaling, frame interpretation, and HDR color grading workflow so you can maximize the potential of this budget-friendly setup. So if you are new here, make sure to subscribe, and I will see you in the next deep dive. It's going to be a good one.